好的。
哦。OK。So the Lord appears by His mercy to these to the priests. The priests are saying, "You're very kind to us. We have no qualification, but you're so kind. You've come to show yourself before us."
就对主说，您如此仁慈，虽然我们并没有资格，但是您好心的就在我们眼前出现了。
We have to apologize. We don't know how to properly worship you because of our ignorance.
我们必须要向您道歉，因为我们并不知道如何恰当的崇拜你，因为我们都如此愚昧。
So, just like in the deity, when we worship in the temple, it's out of the mercy of the Lord that He appears in the deity for our benefit.
就像神像，庙里的神像，主是特别的仁慈，他是为了我们的好处显现的。
We cannot see the transcendent, we cannot see the spiritual form of the Lord, but we can see Him in the form of the deity.
We can't see the spiritual form of the Lord, but we can see Him in the form of the deity.
We have to see the Lord when He appears in things like stone and wood. Then we can see Him, but we cannot see Him in His transcendental spiritual form.
形象显现的时候，我们见到了主，但是我们看不见主的超然的灵性形体。
So it's out of His kindness that He comes in that form of the deity.
所以他出于仁慈，便以神像的形象显现了。
We are ignorant. We don't know how to properly serve the Lord.
我们十分愚昧，我们并不知道如何正确地服务主。
So in the same way the Lord appeared to Maharaj Nabi, it was just simply His causeless mercy.
同样的，主，至尊主也是出于无缘的仁慈显现在 Nabi 眼前。
So the priest, they're praying to Lord Vishnu. They're thanking Him for being so kind that He has come before them in this place where they performed the sacrifice.
祭司们就这样向主祈祷，感谢主在祭祀场上亲自显现了。
And they say, "You've given us the most valuable benediction. You've blessed us because we have been able to see you, your form, your transcendental form."
祭司们就说，您给了我们最珍贵的这个礼物，以您超然的形象显现。
So Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, he says he's equal to everyone. He doesn't have any friends or enemies, but he has a special feeling for his devotees.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说，他对所有众生都一视同仁，他没有朋友。
Krishna comes into this world, and
he 钟爱他的奉献。
Yeah, his business in coming into this world is to satisfy the devotees.
Krishna 降临这个世界，目的是满足他的奉献者。
He can destroy the demons. That's easily done. He doesn't have to come to do that.
恶魔的摧毁要摧毁恶魔轻而易举，他用不着亲自
He can just give them a heart attack. He can just bite because he's there in the heart. He just give them a heart attack and they fall dead. The Lord is in the heart of everyone. So he's in the heart of the demons. So if he wants, he can just give them a heart attack and then they fall dead. Or if he wants, he can have some of the different demigods, some of these different agents, they can come and they can kill the demons. But this time when he has come in the place where Maharaj Nabi was doing the sacrifice, his real purpose in coming was to please the king and his other assistants who were all devotees. He has no other purpose in coming but to please his devotees. So great sages, they get rid of all the dirty things in their heart by remembering the Lord's transcendental qualities. And they've detached themselves, they've fully detached themselves from the material world. They have no material desires. But they take pleasure in hearing about your wonderful pastimes, your qualities. And even for these great souls, the great sages, even for them, to get your personal association is very rare. So the priests doing the sacrifice, they can understand they're very, very fortunate. Because even these great sages who are so detached from the material world, they don't get that opportunity very often. And so great sages, they have to be satisfied just talking about the Lord and remembering his pastimes. They don't get the personal association. So the priests can understand they're so fortunate. So they pray to the Lord that we may not be able to remember you at the time of our death. But we know you're very affectionate to your devotees.
We know
So please, can you please help us to remember you and to chant your holy name and to remember your qualities and pastimes?
您能否帮助我们意念您唱诵您的消时光和您的品质?
Because we know this will help us to get rid of all of our sinful reactions from our life.
因为我们知道这就能帮助我们去除我们生命中所有的罪恶反应。
So we may be doing devotional service in the temple, we may be doing so many things in material life, we may forget about the Lord at the time of death.
我们可能在庙中做很多服务，我们可能在我们的物质生活当中，履行了种种的活动，可能我们在生命临终的时候就忘记主了。Yeah,
we may be in some disease condition, our mind may be out of control, we can't remember him.
我们可能患病，也可能心意失控，可能想不起主。
So we pray to the Lord, please help us that when we have to leave the body, we just pray that we can be able to remember you.
所以我们可以向主祈祷，请主帮助我们在离开躯体之际能够记住主。
Right, this is the final examination in life comes at the time of death, the end of life, when we have to leave the body. You have to have the mind fixed on the Lord.
所以在我们生命临终之际，这就是我们的期末考试，如何让心意专注于主。
Prabhupada says the real success in life is to remember the lotus feet of the Lord at the time of death.
是的，爸爸说，生命的真正的成功就在于在临终之际能够想着主的莲花足。
Krishna says in the 8th chapter, Bhagavad Gita, whatever we remember at the time of death, we will get that state at the end of life.
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》第八章中说, 无论一个人在临死的时候想着怎样的情景,
在下一世他就到达那。 Tam tam me vaiti kunteya sadatat bhava bhavitaha. But then Krishna says, one who can remember me, then he will come to me without fail.
Krishna又说,
So that is the perfection of life. To be able to remember Krishna. That is the final exam. And we get so many exams. When we were at school, we got exams. In the college, we got exams. Then you got driving exam. To get your driving license, you have to pass the driving test.
我们从小到大上学，甚至上大学，都要经历很多的考试。我们要取得驾照，也要通过驾校的考试。
So there's so many tests also we get in life, different people testing us. Sometimes the wife is testing the husband's testing the wife.
我们在生活当中呢，不同的人跟不同的考试，妻子考丈夫，丈夫考妻子。
Sometimes the employer is testing the worker.
雇主他就考这个受雇的人员。
But the real test comes at the end of life. Krishna will test all of us, how much we can remember him.
但是在临终的时候, 是真正的考试就来临了。Krishna会考我们，看我们。
So there was a great king in South India named Kulu.
能不能记住他?
There was a great king in South India named Kulashekar. So he has a famous prayer. Krishna Twadiya Padapankaja Panjarantam Adyaiva Me Vishatu Manasara Jahamsa Prana Prayana Kapaye Kapavata Pitaye Kantavaro Dhanavido Smaranam Kutaste. Maharaj Kulashekar is praying, said, let my mind be fixed on Krishna. So he said, let me die now while I can chant the holy name of Krishna. If I have to wait till I die, normally I may not be able to chant because my throat will be all choked up. So better I die now while I can still chant.
So
people of South India, they all know this prayer, it's very famous. They all pray like Kulashekar. So the priests, they introduced the king, because the priests were doing the sacrifice on behalf of the king, so they introduced the king to Lord Vishnu. So they tell Lord Vishnu, here is the great King Nabi, and his goal, what he wants, the reason why we did this sacrifice is, this king, he wants to have a son like you. And then they tell Lord Vishnu, they say, you know, this king, he's like a person who has come to you, he's coming to you. He said, you are actually like the rich man, and he's coming to you. He's begging, like someone begging for a little grain, for a little piece of rice. Lord Vishnu, you could give him anything. You could take him to heaven. You could even take him back to Godhead if you want. But he's coming to you and he's just asking you to give him a son. So the priests, they feel a little ashamed that they're doing the sacrifice for this king to get such a foolish benediction. The Lord could give us any kind of position we wanted, but this king, he's just saying, I just want to have a son. So Lord Chaitanya, he prayed that he said, Nadanam na janam na sundarim kavitam va jagadisha kamaye mama janmani janmanishware bhavatad bhaktir ahaitakitvai. Lord Chaitanya prayed that all he wanted, birth after birth, was devotional service. A devotee doesn't want anything, shouldn't want anything material. Shouldn't want wealth, he shouldn't want followers, he shouldn't want to enjoy the opposite sex. At least we don't ask Krishna for anything material like that. That's not how we approach Krishna. If we approach Krishna for something material, then that's not pure devotional service.
如果我们怀着物质的
devotee doesn't ask to go to the heavenly planets, or he doesn't ask for liberation. Devotee doesn't mind, can take birth in the material world again and again. He just wants to stay a devotee, just prays that he can always be a devotee. So this Maharaj Nabi, he wanted a son who was just like Vishnu, he wanted a son who was just like God. So that's sense gratification.
Maharaj Nabi 想要一个像 Vishnu 那样的儿子, 这是 感官享乐。
That is not for devotional service, obviously. You don't want a son like that for devotional service. A devotee just wants to do service. Devotee doesn't want to ask Krishna, give me this, give me that. So it's important that we have to worship the lotus feet. We have to take shelter of the lotus feet of devotees, great devotees, and they can guide us, they can protect us from these material desires.
因此这一点非常重要，我们应该崇拜伟奉献者，伟大奉献者的莲花族，托庇于奉献者，请求奉献者来保护我们，指引我们来摆脱这种物质欲望。Yeah,
to have material desires is very easy. Everybody can have material desires, and we can be taken away, carried away by the strong material desire.
有物质的欲望是非常的容易的，一个人很容易就会被他的物质欲望的波涛所卷走。So
the only way we can overcome these material desires is by taking shelter of great devotees who are freed, who have conquered over the material energy.
唯一能够摆脱物质欲望的方法
So a devotee shouldn't have any desire like this for sense gratification.
Mm.
So Maharaj Nabi, he has material desires. He's a devotee, but still he's got this very strong material desire to have a son.
Maharaj Nabi, 他虽然是奉献者，但是他有这样的强烈的物质欲望。So
the sages are telling him how he could have overcome this material desire, that he should have taken shelter of a great devotee. If we don't serve the devotees, then we will never get out of Maya. Because Maya is Krishna's energy, very difficult to conquer. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Devi Hesha Gunamayi Mama Maya Duratyaya. Krishna's Maya, very difficult to overcome. We cannot conquer it.
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》当中就这样说道， Krishna 的Maya是很难征服的，我们是无法征服。
But a devotee who surrendered to Krishna, he can conquer it.
但臣服了Krishna的奉献者就能够征服。
So by the association of Krishna's devotees, one would lose the attraction for material opulences.
通过和奉献者联谊，就能够失去对物质富裕的吸引。
When we're serious about getting free of Maya, then we become able to take advantage of the association of devotees.
我们真诚地希望摆脱玛雅的时候，就能够很好地利用与奉献者的联谊了。Even
a little association with devotees, even for a fraction of a second, can help us to get free of Maya.
即便跟奉献者的一点点联谊，跟奉献者的片刻的联谊，也能帮我们摆脱玛雅的执着。
And if we want to get devotion for Krishna, we must take the association of advanced devotees.
如果我们想获得对 Krishna 的奉爱，必须要跟进步奉献者的联谊。
So to get the blessings of the devotee is very important.
因此。 得到奉献者的祝福，这一点是至关重要的。
We have to take the dust from the feet of the great devotees.
我们必须要从伟大奉献者的足下取得他的足下的尘土。We
have to find those pure devotees who have no material desire to enjoy the material world.
我们必须要找到这样的纯粹奉献者，他们没有享受物质世界的物质欲望。And
then associate with these devotees and develop their qualities.
之后与这样的奉献者联谊，发展他们的品质。And
then we will never be influenced by Maya.
以这种方式，就永远不会受到玛雅的影响。So
the sages are appreciating the wonderful activities of the Lord.
这些圣者们就赞赏主的奇妙的活动。And
they apologize to him, that they say we are very stupid, our intelligence is not very good, We did this big sacrifice just to get you to give a son for this king.
他们向主道歉，我们非常愚蠢，我们没有什么智慧，我们举行这个盛大的祭祀，只是代表这个国王向您讨取一个儿子。
We brought you here just for some insignificant material motive.
我们把你邀请到这里，只是为了一个微不足道的物质的动机而来。
We've made an offense to you by doing like that.
我们这么做是，对您做下了冒犯。
Please forgive us and give us your mercy.
请宽恕我们，给我们您的仁慈。
So sometimes like that, before, you know, before doing the sacrifice, they didn't think about it very carefully. The king asked them to do the sacrifice, so they just agreed.
在举行这个祭祀之前呢，他们并没有仔细的思索。这国王要求他们举行了祭祀，他们就答应了。
But then when they did the sacrifice and they actually saw the Lord come there, then they understood, wow, you know, we brought the Lord here just for this, just to, so the king could have a son.
但是他们真正举行了祭祀之后，就亲眼见到了主，然后那时候明白了，哦，我们把主邀请来了，只是为了让这个国王有个儿子。
Pure devotees, those who are pure,But they would just depend on the Lord's mercy. They won't go and trouble the Lord that come and can you give me this?
纯粹的奉献者，他们只是会祈求主的仁慈，他们不会给主找麻烦，让主来给他们这个，给他们那个。
Yeah, they just wait. And if the Lord comes, then they will see the Lord. If he doesn't come, then they don't trouble him.
如果主来了，他们就能见到主；如果不来，他们也不会打扰主。
Even big demigods like Brahma and Shiva, even they often don't see the Lord.
即便像 Brahma、Shiva 这样的伟大半神人们，也不能够常常见到主。
But still, somehow these priests were so powerful.The Lord came. He responded to their sacrifice and their prayers.
但是这些祭师们是这么有力量，主就回应了他们，在祭祀当中就亲自降临了。
Yeah, we shouldn't worship the Lord to get material things.
我们不应该为了得到物质的事物来崇拜主。
In the beginning, initiation, when we begin bhakti, when we first become devotees, we may have material desires.
刚开始，当我们刚刚得到启迪的时候，刚开始 bhakti 的时候，可能我会有一些物质欲望。
At that time, we're not really devotees because we have so many material desires.
在那时候，我们还算不上真正的奉献者，因为我们有太多的物质欲望。
But by coming into Krishna consciousness and by doing devotional service, gradually we get purified.
但是通过进入 Krishna 知觉，通过服务，我们渐渐的就得到了净化。
Some people, they will just disturb.Krishna or the Supreme Lord Vishnu, they will disturb him by asking for their material desires.
有的人呢，他们只是打扰 Krishna, 打扰 Vishnu, 请他们来满足自己的物质欲望。
Krishna knows, or Vishnu knows, these people just have, you know, they're not very advanced devotees. So he just satisfies their material desires.
Krishna, Vishnu 知道这些人并不是进步的奉献者，所以就会满足他们的物质欲望。
But a pure devotee, he doesn't have any desire. He doesn't want anything. He just wants to worship the Lord.
纯粹的奉献者并没有物质欲望，也不需要满足什么，他们只是崇拜主。
He will just do whatever the Lord wants him to do.
无论主希望他们做什么，他们就去做。
So that's the difference between karma and bhakti. The one who's doing bhakti doesn't have any desire.
这是 karma 和 bhakti 的区别。当一个人他从事 bhakti 的时候，没有什么欲望。
But people doing karma, they have desires, what they want.
但当人们从事 karma 的时候，他们有欲望，有所求。
So these priests, they were like karmic brahmanas. They were doing karmic rituals. They wanted to get, so they apologized to Vishnu that we're very sorry, we troubled you.
这些祭司们，他们是 karmic brahmana, 他们从事的是 karma 的仪式，所以他们向主道歉，哎，我们给你找麻烦了。
Yeah, we shouldn't bring you here for such a foolish material desire.
我们不应该为了这个邀请到这里。
So this way the priests bowed to Lord Vishnu, and Lord Vishnu was very pleased with them.
所以就这样，祭司们就向主，顶拜，那主对他们感到很满意。
He told them, he said, I'm very satisfied, I'm very pleased with your prayers. Everything you spoke was true.
所以主为什么就对他们说，我对你们的祈祷感到非常满意，你们所说的都是真的。
He said, now you've been asking, you asked me for a son who's like me. The king wants to have a son who's like me. This is a bit difficult to do.
国王想要一个，你像我这样的儿子，但是这是很难做到的。
Yeah, he said, there's no other person like me. And there's nobody equal to me. I'm above everyone. I'm the supreme person.
在这个世界上，没有谁像我这样，因为我是至尊的人。
But you're good brahmanas.And you chanted your mantras very nicely, so I should fulfill your desire.
但你们都是优秀的 brahmana, 你们就非常完美的唱诵你们mantra, 我应该满足你们的欲望。
So, brahmana has, you know, brahmanas, they speak something, it should be true.
Brahmana,无论说的些什么都应该得到实现。
The Brahmana represents the mouth of the personality of Godhead.
Brahmana, 他们代表了至尊性格神首的口。
So when a Brahmana eats, it's understood that the Lord is eating himself.
当 Brahmana 进食的时候，可以理解是主在亲自的进食。
So usually they feed the brahmanas first, and then they feed the other people.
通常他们首先就给 brahmana 请 brahmana 进食，然后再给别的人提供食物。
And whatever a brahmana says cannot be changed; it has to happen.
无论 brahmana 说出什么话，都不应该改变，而且必须得兑现。
So these brahmanas who did this ritual, they were like demigods. They were very powerful.
举行这些仪式的 brahmana 是非常有力量，就像半神人一样。
That's how they were able to get the Lord to come to the sacrifice.
因此，他们才能使主在祭祀的现场亲自显现。
Okay, so then Lord Vishnu tells them, there's nobody equal to me, so I will expand myself and I will come as the sun. So this is the power of the Supreme Lord, because He's God, He can do that. He can expand Himself and He can come. You'll take birth in the womb of the wife of the king, and you'll come as their son. And in this way, people will know that the Lord is, that He is one. When He incarnates, he will preach the message of the Supreme Lord.
人们知道主是一，但是当他化身显现的时候，他会传教主的荣耀。
So then the Lord Vishnu disappeared, and then the wife of the king was sitting there, and she heard everything, and she understood what was happening.
主Vishnu说完这番话后就消失了，国王的妻子王后就坐在那里，听到了所发生的所有对话，而且也明白了一切。
Yeah, when they do a sacrifice, the king's wife has to be there. They sit together, husband and wife. So in this way, the Lord agreed to come as their son. He came as Rishabhdev. Okay, so any questions?
Krishna知觉中真正有爱、有甜美的关系，平常是怎样行为及表征的呢？若在Krishna知觉中真正有了爱、有了品味，夫妻之间没有感情了，还能继续生活吗？感谢你。
Chandra Vilas, this question is that if the devotee have love and also have sweet relationship, what's his behavior, his or her behavior and symptom? And if the devotee have love and taste in devotional service, and there is no feeling between husband and wife. 夫妻没有感情了，然后怎么？他们还能继续生活在一起吗？Can they continue to live together? Should they continue to live together?
Yes, they can live together. They can continue to live together. They have no feeling, but ideally the husband and wife should both be devotees. They can live together, and that way they can live together in Krishna consciousness, serving Krishna.
理想的状态是 夫妻都是奉献者, 这样呢, 他们就能一起生活, 生活, 服务 Krishna.
If the wife is a devotee, the husband's not a devotee, then it's more difficult, but still they can do it if the husband is agreeable, if the husband doesn't have objection.
如果妻子是奉献者,丈夫不是奉献者,就有一些难度。但是呢,如果丈夫同意不反对,
because if you have children, ideally when you have children, the father and mother should both be there. If there's only the mother, then it's difficult. The children need to also see father. So children need to have a natural home. Natural home means parents, means both mother and father. If there's only one, then it's not very natural.
孩子们需要一个天然的家，自然的家庭，那又意味着孩子们是需要父母双亲的。如果只有一位单亲的话，是不自然的家庭。
And then once the children grow up, then it's not important if you live together or not.
如果孩子长大成人了，那夫妻是不是生活在一起就不重要了。
If you want, you can live together. If you don't, you can separate. It doesn't make a difference.
如果你愿意的话，可以共同生活；如果不愿意的话，可以分开。
Of course, sometimes you have one may be devotee and one's not. One who's not a devotee, then they want to cook meat, and they want to do all kinds of things which are not Krishna conscious. So it doesn't make a very nice environment for the home.
如果一方是奉献者，一方不是奉献者，那有一方呢就想要做肉或者做不是 Krishna 觉得活动。
Yeah, very difficult to live together like that, because you eat different kinds of food, you have different activities, very different lifestyle.
因为他们吃的不一样，他们活动又不一样，所以共同生活就很难，因为他们的生活方式不一样。
A devotee likes to sleep early, wake up early, but people who are not devotees, they sleep late and they get up late.
奉献者们喜欢早睡早起，非奉献者喜欢晚睡晚起。
Very different lifestyle.
So, 截然不同的是,
so living together can be difficult.
这样共同生活就很难。
What's the first part of the question?
The first part is that if the devotee have love and have sweet relationship, what's the devotee's behavior? And what's the symptom of
Is that love and sweet behavior, is that in relation between husband and wife she's talking about?
Not exactly, but general
They have love for Krishna. Love and sweet behavior, very nice. Yeah, then the home is peaceful. People are happy together with each other. They don't argue. So that would be very nice.
如果是有爱、有甜美的关系，家庭就会平和、快乐，不会争吵，会美好。
They'll keep the home clean and they'll be regulated in their activities. They should be.
他们的家庭非常清洁，生活有规律。
The home would be more in the mode of goodness. Devotee wants to cultivate the mode of goodness. It's helpful for Krishna consciousness.
奉献者希望培养善良属性，这有助于Krishna知觉。
Is that helpful, Chandra Vilasini? I don't know. Ask Chandra.
Chandra Vilasini, 这个回答对你有没有帮助呢？不说他不知道，对你有没有帮助？
<笑>好的，Gordon，那我们下一个问题吗？
啊，可以。
好的，下一个问题是新疆的蒋秀辉马大吉。 啊，川智伟达吉尼玛达吉说有帮助，谢谢您。<笑>好，新疆的蒋秀辉玛达吉顶拜咕噜，我现在的状态是特别的平静，对外界没有任何的反应，没有挣钱的欲望，对生活也没有任何的激情，对孩子、老公、妈妈都很平淡，没有任何依附，只是为了履行职责而履行职责。 让家人感觉我没有爱心和感情，请问Guru这种状态对吗？
Yes, not good. It shouldn't be like that.
不好，不应该是这样。
You have to understand your duty, your prescribed duty, that you have children, you have a family, you have to show some care and concern for them.
你要明白你的职责，你有家，你有孩子，你应该对他们表示出你的关心和照料。Krishna
is in the heart of all of your family knit there, the family and relatives. Krishna is also in their heart.
Krishna 在您的家属的心中。
So you have to see Krishna in them, and you have to take more care of them and help them, make them feel happy and satisfied with you. Krishna consciousness is not just only worshipping Krishna in the temple or in the deity. You have to see Krishna in everyone's heart.
Krishna知觉不是只是在庙宇当中崇拜神像，你要在每个人心中看到Krishna.
Your behavior is giving people the bad impression about devotees.
您的行为就使人们给对奉献者造成了不好的不良印象。
People will end up, they'll talk about you and they'll say you don't take care of your family, you don't have any interest in your family. It's not good.
最后人们就会议论，就说你也不管家，也不照顾家庭，就这样不好。
You just simply get a bad name for Krishna conscious devotees. You make enemies.
Krishna 知觉，给 Krishna 知觉带来了不良的名声，然后您只会树敌。
I invite you to try to change this and try to develop a more loving, caring relationship with your family.
我建议你改变你的行为，来照料你的家庭，来向他们表达你的爱。
Just like Arjuna had to fight, Arjuna had to do what he didn't want to do, but it was his duty. Krishna wanted him to do it.
Arjuna 不想作战，但是他必须要履行职责。Krishna 希望他这样去做。
So I advise you try to change that situation in your home.
我建议您在家中改变这种情况。
下一个问题。
Sorry, 下一个问题是扰人帕布。感谢马哈拉吉，感谢翻译和主持。经典中向主奉献的祷文如此的美妙、虔诚和奉爱，我们学不来，只能为自己的物质或灵性的那点事儿祈祷，怎么办呢？只能欣赏那比王的祈祷，无法模仿。
Good morning.
Yes, the prayers in the scripture is so beautiful. We cannot imitate those beautiful prayers in the scripture. We can only pray for our little material or spiritual things. We cannot make those beautiful prayers. What to do?
Well, according to our ability, we do what we can. Krishna is pleased by the devotion. It's not by the scholarship.
We just 根据个人的能力，依照个人的能力去做事情。Krishna 是对我们的奉爱而感到满意的。
Now, like these people, these priests, they were offering their prayers. They were, first of all,
this question about offering prayers, that we cannot make very beautiful prayers.
The Lord is pleased by our devotion. Dhruva Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj, they were young children. They could offer prayers pleasing to the Lord. We can do our best.
像这些圣人们供奉那么美丽的祷文，主是对我们的奉爱满意。像朱尔玛尔、普拉玛尔，他们都是小孩子，他们献上了祷文，也取悦了主。
So the Lord wants our devotion. He's not so much concerned about the scholarship and the praise.
主他是会为我们的奉爱感到满意，他主不会太在意我们的我们所谓有多少学识。
But when we're actually devoted, then Krishna can speak through the devotee. He can direct us. He can compose the prayers on our behalf.
我们成了奉献者，主会通过我们的口来说话，会指导我们的言语，他会代表我们，主会代表我们来编写出美丽的祷文。
Just like Prabhupada wrote his Krishna book, he said, I have not written this, Krishna has written through me.
就像圣帕拉德写了 Krishna 快乐的权益书，卡帕说不是我写的，是 Krishna 在写的。
Krishna Das Kaviraj wrote Chaitanya Charitamrita, He prayed to all the deities of Krishna to help him, to inspire him.
Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami 撰写了永恒的 Chaitanya 经 Chaitanya Charitamrita. 他向所有的神像祈祷，帮助他来撰写这本书籍。
He went to Madan Mohan and Govindaji and Gopinath and prayed for their mercy.
他来到 Madan Mohan, Govindaji, Gopinath 神像面前，祈求他们的仁慈。
And then also Baladev Vidyabhusan, when he wrote his commentary on Vedanta Sutra, he prayed to Govindaji. And at that time, Govinda spoke the commentary of Vedanta Sutra.
那个时候，格温德基就讲出了对于维丹塔苏特的评述。
So Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, "I carry what you like, and I preserve what you have."
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》当中说：“无者我给予，有者我保存。”
So we have to just take shelter of Krishna and.Depend on his mercy.
We just need to trust Krishna, rely on Krishna's mercy.
Yeah. Any other question? Sati, how you want to know?
还有问题，还有三个问题，姑爹。嗯。在穆坎德。卡入，我不知道智敏马代吉，顶拜虔诚的顶拜咕噜的莲花族，然后请问咕噜，传教中帕布不能给马代吉传教，马代吉不能给帕布传教，这是不是躯体化的概念，还是这是一个礼仪
？Yes, it's more etiquette.But generally, women should preach to women and men preach to men.
一般而言，女士向女士传教，男士向男士传教。
But there may be a situation, there's no other men. So the Mataji is there, they will have to speak to the men. One man comes, he's the only man, so the ladies will speak to him.
如果没有男士在场的情况下，女士也可以向男士传教。比如说来了一个男士，那只能由这个女士向他传教了。
It shouldn't be one man and one woman. There should be, you know, two men. Ideally, there should be two men speaking to two men. They can speak to a woman, or.But two ladies speaking to one man is not very good. Two men can speak to one woman, that's okay. But two women to speak to one man, not very good.
所以不应该是一对一，只有一个男士或一个女士。可以是两位男性向一位女性传教，这是可以的。但是两位女性向一位男性传教，这不太好，不好。
One man coming. One man should not really come on his own to association.
男性单独的来联谊。
Yeah. He should come with some other man, or should come with his wife.
另外一个男性，或者和自己的妻子一同来。
Then it's all right. If he brings his wife, you meet a man, you should meet the man with his wife. You know, better his wife is also there. To speak to the man alone is not very good. Yeah, Mataji is saying, well, this is the bodily conception of life. Yes, it is. We have material bodies. We have to recognize the distinction between the bodies. We have to... Yeah, there are different, it's different for men and it's different for women. There's different bodies and so it's different circumstances. Women have to be protected. Women shouldn't be alone. They should be protected. That means they come with their friend, they come with another lady, or they come with their husband.
Guru, 那个智敏巴塞基问，为什么就是两位女性向一位男士传教不太合适呢？
Two ladies and one man. Well, the two ladies mean it's a difficult situation for a man. It's a dangerous situation for a man to be in. It's not the proper condition for one man to be there with two women. He can get into Maya much easier. Two men are there, they can help each other. But two women, they don't help each other. Not when there's a man involved. When there's one man involved. If one woman gets a liking for one man or starts to feel some relationship for one man, then she doesn't care that she's with another woman. But two men, you know, one man, he may get attached to the one woman, but the other man is there to you know, to be with him and to watch him and to hold on to him.
，就拽住那个男性。
we say one man, one woman together is dangerous because man is like butter and the woman is like fire.
我们说一个男性和一个女性在一起很危险，因为男子就像黄油，女子就像火。
And when you have two women, then it's like two fires, big fires, becomes a bigger fire.
如果是两位女性呢，就是两团火了，这个火更大。
The butter melts very quick.
就是黄油它融化得更快。
So, we have to be careful in dealing between the men and the women.
所以在男性和女性之间的交往过程当中要十分的小心谨慎。
好的 ，Good day。下一个问题也是智敏曼大姬的问的，请问上次讲课说灵性世界生孩子，只需要念诵一些祷文就可以了，为什么灵性世界还要生孩子呢？灵性世界也有夫妻吗
？In the spiritual world, yeah, there's husband and wives, but. But generally, we say they're not much worried about having children.
灵性世界也有夫妻，但是他们对于生孩子这件事并不是太担心。
Because they're so happy, they're so busy and absorbed in service to Krishna, they don't think about having children.
因为他们在服务 Krishna 过程。
Devotional service is so satisfying. It gives pleasure. They don't think about these bodily things.
奉献服务是如此令人满足，他们想也不想这个躯体上的事情。
Spiritual world, you have a spiritual body.You don't have these senses like what we have with the material body.
灵性世界是有灵性的躯体，不像我们现在的是一个物质躯体，物质的感官。
Material body, material senses, full of material desires. So much agitation, disturbance.No happiness, no real pleasure.
物质的躯体，物质的感官，有物质的愿望，有那么多的令感官不安的事物，那么让人的不满意，有那么多的不快乐。
Spiritual world is a place of eternal bliss and knowledge.
灵性世界充满着永恒、极乐和知识。
In this world, we're just suffering, so much misery, so many problems, so much anxiety, so much ignorance.
而在这个世界上，有那么多的受苦受难，那么多的。问题、焦虑，那么多的愚昧。
But in the higher planets, in the planets of the demigods, sometimes they give birth there.
但是在更高的星宿，那半神之宿的星宿，他们会生孩子。
And the demigods there, the women there, they give birth without pregnancy.
在那里，在那个半神人的那星球上，女子生孩子，她不需要经历怀孕。
Not so much suffering.
没有那么多的痛苦。
this place, we suffer. Women, the woman suffers for 9 months carrying the child in her womb.
而在这个世界上有那么多痛苦，女子她需要怀胎9个月才能诞下这个孩子。
Shaggy, 问题。
好的，最后一个问题，Divya Shakti 问的提问的，顶拜 Guru， 所有的物质世界都在运旦之阳威士怒的莲花镜中吗？
所有的什么？
物质世界，
所有的物质世界都在运旦之阳威士怒的莲花镜中吗？
Does all the material world exist contains in the Garbhodaksha Vishnu, the lotus stems of Garbhodaksha Vishnu?
In one universe, there's one Garbhodaksha Vishnu. So there's one lotus there, and in that stem of the lotus, all of the planets of the universe are.There, in the stem of the lotus. There's one Garbhodakshayi Vishnu in each universe. There are many universes, so there are many Garbhodakshayi Vishnus in each universe.
有许多宇宙，所以许多宇宙当中，就是每个宇宙有一位Garbhodakshayi Vishnu.
So each Garbhodakshayi Vishnu lays on the Garbhodak ocean, and he has the lotus flower coming from his navel.
所以在运旦之阳就有一位 Garbhodaksha Vishnu 就从他的肚脐上长出一朵莲花。
And the planets are situated around the stem of the lotus.
而那些星，而这个各个星宿呢，就存在于这个莲花镜的四周。
Yeah, in their subtle form.
是以他们精微的形象形体。
Then Brahma takes birth from the lotus flower, and he does the work of creation.
之后 ，Brahma 就从这朵莲花上诞生了，就开始了创造工作。
First he has to do tapasya.
首先他要进行 tapasya.
Then he gets the power, he pleases Lord Vishnu, and Lord Vishnu guides him how to do the creation.
之后他得到力量，他取悦了 Vishnu 之后得到力量，主 Vishnu 就知道他怎样创造。
Okay, Divya Shakti. Diva Shakti, huh?
Divya Shakti.
Oh, Divya Shakti.
Singapore.
Singapore, Divya Shakti. Okay, Divya Shakti. Hare Krishna.Okay, so Mom,
好，
可以结束啊。
是的，是的 ，Gurudev， 我们今天的问题都回答完了。
Okay，
谢谢您。
Okay， 感谢你们呢 ，Nice and that for all one。
让 Gurudev 给我们带来这么甜美的讲课，然后也感谢 Guru Mani Mataji 甜美的翻译。
对，感谢 Guru Mani， 感谢
Sati。
晚安，
谢谢大家聆听。
Hare Krishna.
好，大家晚安，Good day，晚安，顶拜年，妈祖，
顶拜年。